can just on this map. Mm-hmm. And you can make notes, or you can just highlight, circle, mark somehow where in the U.S. you think solar power is prevalent, is common, or as being used at all. And then, like I said, there are no right or wrong answers, so just kind of your general impressions.
I'm not aware. I'm not aware, so I can't really say, because I'm not aware of where it's used the most. I haven't did that much research on that, so
okay.
I really can't.
Do you think there are any particular types of communities where it's more likely to occur, or any, like, geographic areas that would make it more likely to occur?
I'm just going to put this here, but I'm not, like I said, I don't have enough knowledge of it.
Okay. And why Texas?
I'm thinking the largest states, because you need more energy.
Okay. Sure. Okay. And then same question, but for our state. Like, where, either from firsthand knowledge or just kind of like assumptions that you would make about the types of communities, or, like I said, the conditions that might be right for solar, where do you know of or think there might be solar in Georgia?
Probably be a lot of farm areas, but I can't really tell you exactly. I just know, I would think more farm areas that you see, they will probably use it more, benefit from it more.
Okay.
But and I'm not 100% on where over here. I'm just going to go this way. I'm not, I just know the farm areas. I'm sorry.
Okay, that's fine. And you can just make a note down there. Just say farm areas.
Okay.
In general.
Okay.
Okay, and I already asked you if you know any friends, families, neighbors that have rooftop solar, and you said no one that
no.
you know of has it.
I didn't.
Okay. All right, so now we're going to quickly run through the food access questions, because I know
okay.
you got to go.
Yeah, I got about 5 more minutes, because I left Shauna, and she's working the front end of phones.
Okay, okay.
So that's why I got to go.
So we'll just quickly run through these. Can you tell me kind of what your food routine is? Like your daily, do you do 3 square meals a day? Do you, kind of what your daily meal routine is?
Yes, I do try to do 3 meals a day. They're not big meals, small meals, but I do.
Okay.
I do believe in that, 3 meals a day.
And do you snack between meals?
I do fruits most of the time, grain food, Nutri-Grain bars, something like that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And when you're having meals, are they sit-down meals? Are they kind of on the go,
sit-down meals. I'm a sit-down person.
Yeah.
Yes, sit-down
Solo or with family, or who are you usually eating with?
Well, to be honest with you, the majority of the day is, by myself, and then at night with the family.
Okay. And I think I forgot to ask at the beginning of the interview, mm-hmm. who all is in your household?
It's 4 of us and
4.
Malila.
Okay. Okay. So it's just to know if you were just feeding yourself, or if you were, if there were other people in the home.
Yeah, it's full of us.
That's, okay. All right. And so how often are you cooking your own meals versus, like, buying prepared food?
I do a lot of cooking my own food. I mean, as far as dinner time, because, of course, most of the time I'm not there for breakfast or lunch. I'm not at home. And, mm-hmm. well, there, if I... It's almost impossible to go at lunch and get back in an hour time.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
So dinner mm-hmm. time is what I normally cook.
Yeah.
So it's not every day, 7 days.
Yeah.
Some weeks it might be 5 days.
Yeah.
Some
yeah.
it might be 6.
Are you typically packing something to bring to lunch for you, or you go out?
Normally I bring it from home. Normally.
All right, so what about grocery shopping? Where do you tend to get your groceries?
Most of the time I get them from Walmart, as far as the local grocery store.
Down in Brunswick.
Brunswick or either Liberty.
Mine is
Liberty, so it's closer to
right,
Liberty.
Definitely.
And I do get some here too, by Low and the Pig, I do.
Yeah, because you're way up at the north end of the county, so
mm-hmm.
that would be closer for you to go. The other direction, right? Okay, and so about how often are you having to go grocery shopping?
I usually go at least once a week. I do.
Okay. And when you go grocery shopping, are you, what's your style?
You know, as far as what I like to purchase.
Like, how you actually go, how you approach the grocery store. Are you like, you have a list and you only go in and get those things on the list? Are you the type that starts on one side and goes up and down every aisle?
Well, normally I have a list of what I need. You see what I'm saying? But most of the time you end up picking up more than what the list say because you something that you might didn't put on the list. But normally I do that. And most of the time, like I know particular meat that I already know we got the breakfast and, you know, the meat that we need for the week. Mm-hmm. You usually do that and pour us milk and butter and things like that.
Yeah, your staple items. Okay. All right. And are you the primary food shopper for your household or somebody else do the...
I am.
And are you also the primary meal
I
prepare?
Am. Yeah, most of the time. Do have a little help most of the time.
Yeah. And are there any challenges that you face with trying to get the food that you need, whether that's financial challenges or access to a store or stores that have the foods available
Nah, Walmart, you can pretty much get anything you want. I mean, anything is in there.
Yeah, so I have some. Found it a little challenging here in McIntosh with just the Bilo and the pig because I have some dietary restrictions.
Oh, okay.
And to have that kind of selection that I'm used to in a bigger city, being able to access some of the foods. So, you know, whenever I'm passing through Savannah or if I have to go up to Athens for work or whatever, I kind of have to plan ahead and stock up
on
things I can get there.
You're right about that. Because it is a little bit limited here in the county. But like I say, because I do shop out, yes, so I don't have no problem.
Yeah. Okay.